Hello and welcome to another episode of How to Adam Audio. My name is Stefan Maurer, and as a product manager, I'm responsible for Adam Audio's product portfolio. In this video, we are going to look into one of the most commonly used measurement charts when it comes to describing the performance of a loudspeaker, the frequency response chart. Generally speaking, a frequency response chart shows amplitude or volume in dB on the vertical y-axis versus frequency in Hertz on the horizontal x-axis, which is usually presented in logarithmic scale. The unit of the y-axis depends on the value that is described. When measuring the frequency response of a speaker, you measure its output in dB SPL over the entire auditory frequency spectrum at a constant input level. SPL stands for sound pressure level and refers to the human hearing threshold. In most cases, a frequency response graph describes the speaker's frequency response on axis. Here, on axis refers to the measurement mic being arranged in the direction the speaker is designed to aim to the listener, more or less the ideal situation. Off-axis and on-axis measurements combined are very often accumulated in directivity charts, but that's a topic for another episode. An ideal loudspeaker would generate the same amplitude for all frequencies across the entire spectrum from 20 Hz to 20 kHz, resulting in a completely flat line in the frequency response chart. To get a better understanding of the curve, imagine a speaker that reproduces a sine wave at, let's say, 1 kHz. If you visualize its output in a frequency chart, you would only see one single point in the graph, namely the amplitude at 1 kHz, given that the speaker doesn't add any harmonics. Now repeat the same process for all other frequencies of the auditory spectrum and add up the resulting dots to make a continuous line. Now you're having the frequency response of the speaker. The perfectly flat frequency response I mentioned earlier is also the objective when designing a studio monitor, because in this case it would not color the sound at all. Reality looks a bit different though. Most speakers do not reproduce the entirety of the frequency spectrum, but bottom out below a certain frequency, which marks the lower limit of the reproduction frequency range. In the frequency response chart, you can usually see a pretty steep decline left of a plateau at the low frequencies on the left-hand side. It's common that the frequency at either -3, -6 or -10 dB below the plateau's level is used as the lower end limit of the frequency range, which you can also find in the speaker's specs. At the upper end of the frequency response, you can find a similar behavior. Here, the -3, -6, respectively -10 dB point below the plateau's level also marks the upper limit of the reproduction range. Reaching the upper limit of the auditory range of someone with perfect hearing, so 20 kHz, is not an issue for basically all modern studio monitors. However, Adam Audio products using AMT tweeters offer tweeter systems that are even more capable than that and that exceed the minimum required frequency range so they can perform effortlessly up to 20 kHz and higher. In between both limits of the reproduction frequency range, the graph usually is not a perfect flat line, but shows more or less ripples and dips, sometimes even bigger valleys and peaks. Such deviations from the ideal straight line can be the result of imperfections of the speaker, or also the result of conscious design decisions to compromise with other aspects of the speaker's performance. Finally, due to physics of the real world. These deviations also reflect the spectral or tonal character of the speaker. While in a studio monitor, a flat frequency response is preferred, following the ideal of neutral representation of the audio. And one more thought, these graphs also can be visually smoothed to look more even or more appealing, but then there's less detail you can take from it. All right, this is it and we hope you enjoyed it. We will explain more key specifications and other measurements in more videos to come in the future. If there are other topics you would like us to look into, please let us know in the comment section below. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Tschüss!